All right. So, a little bit of history. So, I'm very known for my guard or whatever takedowns, but one of the things that I really work a lot is my guard. All right. So, I haven't got my guard passed in competition in the past 11 years. The only guy that really passed my guard as a black belt was Roger, 2005. The first time I got my guard passed, I was a brown belt. So all the way from white belt to brown belt, never got my guard passed and never got mounted. The only thing that happened to me has been takedown sweeps and back takes. But never been mounted. And first time was 1999, I was a brown belt. Renato Miragaia. Actually, there's a pass called Miragaia. He did the pass on the Miragaia pass. And I'm gonna show a little bit of defense from that. And the other one was Roger, couldn't stop him from passing. But from that point on, I was very happy not to have that done to me. So, I'm gonna start in a scenario that I believe it's one of the worst case scenarios. I need a volunteer. You, vem cá. Shit, I'm gonna teach you this barra. All right, so lay down, please. So, just to start off, all right, let's think about three words. Shield, frame, and paddle, all right? So, shield is my knee, frame is my arm, paddle is my foot blocking the hips. I'll go over to you guys into that matter, all right? So, let's talk about, what's your name?
Zaid.
Zaid, yeah. Where are you from?
Jordan.
Jordan? Oh, I have a good friend in Jordan. Good, I like Jordan. I was in Amman not too long ago.
Oh.
All right, so, this guy got this position. Who has been in this position? Bad, right? So, what is my main mistake in this position?
What?
Cross face and here. So, that's a bad situation. So, Zaid, I got you here. I'm not really gonna do any power. Mm. You're probably gonna escape. I just wanna see what's your idea, what's your behavior here. Okay. Let me see, the guy's here. I'm just gonna kind of hug you a little here like a friend. What's your idea? Push, pa, the guy's gonna do this. And I'm still here, and I'm still here, and I'm here.
Yeah.
So, what's the two mistakes he did that we're talking about? Flat and head. Did you fight that?
No.
No, so you're still flat, and now let's switch. So, doesn't matter. They don't pass anyway. So, he's got in this position. I see a lot of happy guard and things like this. All right, so one thing that I'm gonna do, the first thing I'm gonna do is connect my biceps to here. And turn my hip. One thing that I never do is this. I never do that. I keep this open. And I'm gonna be here, pa. So what's your idea now to deal with me here? Shield. That was my first thing. Because now, I'm going to create a distance. I'm going to throw my frame, and I'm going to paddle to go back into the guard. Okay? This, for everything, I'm going to show 10 situations that exactly combination. Shield, frame, move, paddle going to happen. Let me go forward in the game. Mount. He gets the mount. I'm going to escape. Pop. Put the weight down. Turn, shield, frame, paddle, back. He takes the back. I'm gonna escape, pa, pa, he comes to the mount. Shield, frame, paddle, guard. Name it. Stand up. He's gonna cross knee. Shield, keep crossing. Frame, paddle, back. Simple. It's about manage the distance and allowing my movement. Okay? So what we're gonna do, very simple. He's gonna be here. So first thing I have to do is not a movement. It's a micro adjustment. I can't go from here, no. I move what I can. Elbow, pa, 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 and here. That knee is ready for his hip. I'm gonna bump, move, shield. Keep it holding, keep it holding. But now I'm here, right? I'm gonna do an extension. He's already uncomfortable. Frame, block, paddle. Oh, what we got here? An omoplata. What do you got here? Underhook. What do you got here? Pa, face plant. And everything works along. Okay, any questions? No, let's go on the count of three. One, two, hey. One, two, three. Nah, forget about that. Keep your hand on his hip. Keep that hand on his hip. Right hand on his hip. Now, right the hand on his hip. No, right the hand on the hip. Right hand here, pa. You block it here. That knee is looking for the hip all the time, right? So you're gonna bump a little bit, bump, move out, and throw the knee right there, pa. Now it's an extension of your body, yes. And then go right there, and then paddle back to the guard, yes. Boa. Extend, yes, frame. As you extend, Olga, here, as you extend, that hand comes already there. Pa, move, pa, boom, yes. Not really much like this here. So, pa, he's there, boom, boom, and blocking, right? I turn, I mean here. As I come out, though, it's already here.
Pa. Fluid. Oh, okay,
just flow, because from here, you have many options, right? I can go boom, boom, yeah. I can go there, you know, and see what
sometimes
I...
Sometimes I have it very difficult to get the knee inside. It's and too tight.
But then you're gonna have to kind of like move him around, you know?
Dude, that's when you kind of bump, yeah, yeah, yeah. Do a little hip bump.
Doesn't matter. If he tries to sit, go sit. Oh. Yeah, my knees are still there. Yeah. I'm going to talk about this knee a little bit, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, time. Huddle in. Olga, please. Olga, please. All right, our world champion had a question here about the shield, how the shield gonna come in. The thing about jiu-jitsu that people don't understand is that there's always adjustments and feelings, okay? Even before a technique happens, you need to be emotionally connected to it, okay? It's like, for example, if I'm fighting, I don't know, my heaviest guy here, he gets me in that position, and he just squeezes me a lot, am I gonna escape? No, I'm gonna do a micro adjustment to make him uncomfortable. So that's the idea, okay? So the mechanics we already know, but let me imagine we're here, pa, and she got someone that's like moving and the hip is low. She, not big movement, little movement, pa, yeah, oh. Now she got what she wanted. Now, when you put your knee, I don't want the whole knee like this. I want half of it, okay? Because that's where I'm the strongest. Don't let me get close to you. But if it's all the way, and then you can feel a lot of power, all right? So it's just a little bit. So pretty much, one concept that I use this, my knee is always sensitive by any movement that happens on her hip. And that's all. Take your time, get to your side, and keep moving. Let's do it now. Now, I'm gonna hold you a little bit. You're the champion, you can handle it. Ready, go. Stop. See how you like this a little bit? Yes, right there. What did she do now? She reached because my energy is going this way, right? My energy is going here. Once, now I'm away. So she's not pushing against me. She's redirecting my energy because naturally, I wanna go here, yes. And now she's right there, okay? Now, go back. Once you're in this position here, and you, again, Xande, do I always have to put the shield? Again, it's emotional. Maybe I wanna move and put a hook, fine. If that's what you think is it's good for that time, fine, be my guest. But I'm thinking about mainly protection and defense, okay? So, and that knee, I call the sensitive knee, because I might be here, I might try to do this. Right there. There's nothing else this knee gonna do. It's just waiting until I create a space or I make a movement. Now, what happens if I start to go like this? Same thing, now I'm uncomfortable. When I come back, I'm already on the shield and she's already attacking my arm and I have to go back and then it's freedom. And then you guys can do whatever you want for there, okay? Any questions? All right, next one now, it's gonna be more of a live drill, okay? So, Excuse me, my belt. So, lay down, please. Lay down. So, pretty much is this. If I go this side, shoot the framer here. How am I gonna go here? I cannot go. So, it doesn't matter how big I am, how small I am. You have to make your body as strong as possible on your own frame. There's nothing I can do, okay? So what I'm gonna do is this. I'm gonna go to any cut, pa. Okay, and you always keep that distance. That's very important, because look where I have to go. I don't wanna go there. Now pedal, pa, back to the guard, yes. Now go the other side, boom, already there. This hand can, you can kinda like, just reach this hand a little bit. Yeah, that's fine. Because you might be holding the collar. No, like this. Yeah, you might be holding that. Whatever. Ah, Xande, if he holds here. Yes, or now let's get a deeper situation. My knees on the floor, and you have this. No, no, allow me a little bit here. Yes. Rodolfo Vieira, pa. So what's the idea here? It's a pretty bad situation. What should be her idea here? Pull that arm out? No, no. What would you do here? Yes, hide that. Perfect. Because now I have to move. Maybe do this. Bah. She's right there for that. Okay? So let's play around a little cross knee. Bah. So lay down, please. Bah. I go here. Even if I go here, bah. Sneak that knee. Yes. It's over. Bah. Where am I going? There's nowhere I can go. What a champion. Go. A champion. Boa. Boa. You, it's okay. Just keep your hands on me. Okay? Ready? Let me go a little bit. Because I want you to understand where the red zone starts. Right now, you keep me too far away. I want you to, like, imagine I'm a white belt and you play me. Allow me to come a little bit and I, oh. It's like when you're screwing something. There's a moment you feel you're almost there, and that's where you don't want it to get. Ready? Go. Yeah, feel the pressure a little bit. Now, that's, I always look for my hip. I always look for my hip. Go. Boom, right there. Okay, any questions? No? On two, one, two. Don't be so shy. Aqui, ó. Boa, Grace Barra. Chega aí. Go, pass. I'm here. So, it's like a fight, right? Try to punch him in the face. I don't know, try to just reach for a punch. Oh, see, it's there. That's still safe, right?
Yeah.
So, we start from here. I'm just here. That's my zone. Go. It's okay. Oh, I change my grip. I can pull. I'm kind of giving her the side that I want. And I'm always here. Bah. Bah. And then, of course, later on, I'll make my grips or do whatever. Okay? So, pretty much, I'm losing. I'm here. Don't, you can't like this. Stay here because that's I'm strong.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, there's situations sometimes, go down here a second. That like, sometimes the person's like, put it really heavy on you. What I'll do, I'll put my elbow down in and I'll bring my knee under my elbow. And now I can create a stronger frame. You know what I mean? So they all work together. All right? Now we're gonna add a little more things. Please lay down. So she was having an issue here, maybe. When I train Lovato, sometimes that happen a lot. That's.
Attention, competitors and spectators. Please check out the Adidas boot. The Adidas boot. We have former UFC champion.
A little interval for
Luke Rockhold in the house.
Bring Luke Rockhold here. So, she was having a problem taking that leg out, okay? The first thing I can feel, again, is a feeling. She's too soft on her shield. Yeah, more straight, yeah. See, more like this. Don't let me get close. Straight more. Much better, because now this is weak. If this guy is here, I cannot do it. So it's a extreme bone. Now,
What you can do now is turn on your knees almost. Go on your knees, off your shoulder. Yes. Now move away and bring it in. Boom, right there. Okay? So, switch. Which kind of the same situation, put your knee on the floor. Put your knee on the floor. When the guy do the weave pass. But it's kind of the same idea. Right, I'm here. So, one thing that I'm very big on is hand the collar. All right, why the hand the collar? Management, and it's the vital point. If I put my hand in her collar and she doesn't respect, she'll tap. You know what I mean? So a lot of people think about this, but there's a vital point right in front of you. Straight line, okay, pa. Already create an emotional block about her coming in. Am I wrong? Am I right? You guys are falling, right? So let's imagine I don't have that, okay? She's super big hip. Pa, same thing. And sometimes I can't do this, right? So now, extend elbow on the floor. I go on my knees. Oh, and I can go back in. So, go back with the knee. And now, put your knee now. No, knee. Yeah, so pa, she's there. Even if you're here. So I turn my shoulder, I extend, and I go like this. Oh. I have much space to move. I can move as much as I want. I'm literally, all the time, everybody talks about hipscape. I talk a lot about shoulderscape, because if my shoulders are not in a proper position, I can't move where I need to move. Oh, hipscape, and I'm here. That is mad, oh, hipscape, no. I have to adjust my top so I can move sideways. That's why shrimping. I can't shrimp like this. I have to be on my side. I'm almost going on my force here. So now I have going my force, I have moving, I have half guard, I have moving here. So it's about allowing my movement, okay? So, let's bring the weave now. So now the person knows here, they know I have a shield. Now they're gonna go there, pa. Hand the collar, of course, if she hangs in there, pa. Hélio Gracie all day long. All right, and there's one thing that I actually appreciate. When I fight now, the thing that I hear the most, break the collar grip, awesome. And I can do all this stuff. So you wanna create that emotional barrier on them. All of these sometimes, I'll put a hand there. You know, if she drops the head, I can do a loop choke and stuff like this, okay? So now she's heavy here, pa, pa, pa. She's controlling my hand. All right, I have to first manage to do this. If I don't, use your body to hide it. And then sometimes I can do this. But let's imagine they cannot. I go under and I start control to break it. Now I cannot extend. That's one of the most important things in jiu-jitsu, your ability to go in your elbow. You escape anything if you're elbow on the floor. Because now I have way more torque. Put pressure, please, sweetie. Pa, put pressure. Move out, knee on the floor, knee to my chest, and I create space. And here I go, my foot there again. And then I can create whatever I want from here. Okay, so, switch please. You do right to left? Okay, so I'll help her. So she's doing guard here, pa, strong. Maybe I tuck my chin, pa, what are you gonna do? Elbow, elbow, extend an elbow, stop. Nice, yo. Keep moving, keep moving, yeah, yeah. Now, go your knee. Come, isso, Now, knee to your chest, boom, go back in. See, I have to follow her, because if she's here, now she's there, and I have to keep following, and I end up creating space. Will be one movement, maybe two, maybe three. So it's always, loop choke, bah, drag, especially on those nice slipper mats. All right, any question? No? One, two, one, two.
And it's what I do, but when I'm here,
And then what? And then what?
I don't know what.
Attack her neck, po. Now the battle's on. But became personal. The battle gonna happen.
Yes.
I'm not saying that the battle's not gonna happen.
But as long as you can get to the shoulder, it doesn't matter.
Exactly, because see how much he had to run from you?
Yeah. But so if you don't have it, Fundamentais?
Bora, campeã!
Where's the other guy that I was talking to?
Alright, I'll get to you in a second. Alright, Saul does that to me. And then what? Ah, sure, I changed.
Oh, I like this.
The game has changed. Bam. But, you know what I mean? It's always gonna have the exchange.
Yeah, of course.
But if you, because I go from the defensive mode to offensive mode, again, became emotional. Oh, okay. Now she's like, okay, now I'm gonna do this.
As soon as she focused on using her hips on your legs, you can get up on your right arm.
Exactly. Again, because here now I'm doing this and she has to follow me. Yeah. And the hand and the neck is still bugging her a little. Did it? So now she has to do what?
Press that.
Power.
Energy.
She has to waste energy and I'm moving. So it's movement against power. I'm just moving. She's getting tired, which is fine. I'm not saying that this is gonna be perfect right away, but it's about understanding the distance and what's gonna happen later. Does anybody has anyone else to show? Let me see, now's the time that I like. Anything that you do different?
My question is, so the frame is obviously, you know, very, very strong there.
What do I mean?
I think of it necessarily a particular pass, but like...
Okay, that's the dark side.
The dark side.
I don't want you in the dark side.
Right, okay, yeah, so your purpose is like, hey, no, if my frame
yeah,
is here,
my weak point is there. So that's why my frame is like, that's the world that I don't want you to see. That's the dark side of Xande, right. I never show anybody. Well, that's okay, here, man, you can go anytime here.
Neck is there once.
Now you're, yeah. You, if I'm a mean guy, tournament, what else am I gonna do?
Let me go this side.
No, and then I change here, now I do lasso, right. Pie, and I go there. You know, and then I, of course, and then the game opens.
You can't let them lock down the door with a weak side.
I cannot, because your defense for this, like I said, I pass this side too. But then it's a battle against my frame. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So I'm not saying that it's gonna be perfect all the time. You might change, you might not be the strongest one. I have done this for 25 years. That's why I know like many intricacies of it. So for example, if I'm here, what would be the side you have to pass me? Exactly. So when I'm framing, I'm saving that side because everything here is in front of me. And if you stop, I'm always gonna have that. And I'm always keeping you in stake. So yeah, I don't want you to go that side. So if you got to go there, I'm gonna set something up. Yeah, and then I'm here, and then I can do here, but let's see. But I'm still playing. Now it became jiu-jitsu.
Yep, now we're...
Now it became all the story. Okay? I had a question here earlier. So, my jiu-jitsu guy is very basic in a sense of movement because I look for basic positions. In practice, I'll do like beating bolos and stuff like that, but I'm a submission guy. My guard is based on submission. I don't do nothing working on sweeps. My sweep happens if I need to or if he opens for me. There's one place that I love to be. I love to close the guard for a couple reasons. So he made me a question. Xande, that was his question. You hear whatnot situation. When you, look at this. When you put, no. Less. Less is more, guys. So when you put the foot on the hips, do you always close the guard? Not necessary, but I'm gonna bring my intention for that. Why? Why I bring that intention? Had to respect it. And now, if he wants to close the guard, I have to push out. De La Riva, beating Bolo, whatever. So now, if I just go like this comfortable, another guy's here. Okay. So I'm all the time making him respect my movement. And I love close guard because now he has to open guard. A note for my team, we had three of our teammates losing the close guard. Because it's a badass position. It's totally favorite for the guy on the bottom. They have submissions. I have to do a lot of power to open. And I have to open myself sometimes. So I'm always looking for that. When I see I'm gonna fight a tough guy, I'll close the guard. Because now he has to open. He has to worry about all of that things. So So I'm still a big believer in the close guard. So when I'm here, I am looking for the close guard. In a sense, I'm doing this. But now he doesn't like that. And then he goes like that. And then I'm like, oh, okay. And then beating bolos, pa, leg, army drags, whatever you want to do. So it's important for the person now, instead of, okay, oh shit, I have to go away. And then you can involve them the way you want. What time is it? We have enough time. Good. I thought it was... All right. Any questions? Well, I have a guy that's really good at that. Actually, two. I have one that's there too. It's more, I'm always bone, you know what I mean? Bone. It's more when the guy is very like cross the knee and drop the head. Cut the knee across, yeah. I have the gets out, see? I'm always looking for it. So I created space to go up. Okay. There's two ways I do it. When the guy just drop the head, or I be able to come up on my elbow.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
You come up on your elbow and you sit out.
Yeah, because when I go here, right, naturally you wanna go back in.
Right.
That's when I go there. And then I move out, head goes in, and I reach for this.
Okay.
You know? So it's like my hand is there but it's not there. Because see, speaking of loop choke. Pô, quer falar aqui? Quer ensinar o loop choke aí? That's the guy that taught me all my loop chokes. So the thing is, when I put the hand in the collar, I don't tell you, my hand is here. I'm like,
that's soft.
I'm fighting whoever. That's what they're gonna feel. Do you feel anything?
No.
But you know it's there.
Yeah.
And then you might forget about it, and I'm just gonna go like this. So it's like, when I make my grips, I'm soft. I'm not like, see, my grip is there. I don't need that. Why do I need to tell him and put all his focus on it? I'm not here, my hands are soft. See, my hands are still good model hands. And my hands there, see, they didn't even feel it. I'm not gonna, okay, right there. No, right here, boom. Then I can boom, boom, I can pop, boom. Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, buraco do tatu. So push, sit, push down, pan, right there. Rolete, não, magrete, tu rolete, pá.
Oh, that's so nice.
And then you go. Well, if you guys want to know more about it, BJ Library, Rodrigo Pagani series, it's my black belt.
Thank you, Professor. Appreciate it.
So, again, like I said, my guard is all based on submissions. Like, I don't look at this. Nowadays, it's all about I'm all about this. If I had to waste all my energy, I'm gonna waste pulling your arms, your neck. I'm gonna go A, B, A, B, A, B. Do you know what my first sweep is? Scissor.
Oh.
And everything from there. Xande, what sweep you do? Scissor. All right, close the guard. And I'm gonna go here. Pa, what do you do?
What am I gonna do?
Yeah, pa, oh, boom. I'm a plata here, boom. And then everything goes from there. You know? I'm not gonna go here right away, it's too much. Especially nowadays.
Just keep it real basic and then
it's not
there.
It's not basic, it's just that I rather waste my energy by trying to kill you in a good sense than try to sweep you. Mm. Alright, it's 2 points, but what? What's my goal in my guard? Defend and finish. What's my defense? My threat. It's not even my blocks. My shielded frames are just a mask for what I really want, which is to make you worry about me. When I pass people's guard, I'm so comfortable because there's no threat. Because my jiu-jitsu is about finishing you. I don't care. Ah, you swept me, so what? Now you're my doom. Now come in. So what? Did you pass my guard? No. Did you dominate me? No. You look at the referee, oh, referee, I'm the best in the world because I got sweep. Yes. But I didn't see one attack. I have a lot of black belts that I talk to them. I'm like, hey man, why you don't attack? Oh, when I was a blue belt, I used to attack a lot of triangles. Like, what's wrong with being a black belt? I do the same. You know what I mean? So those are concepts that I think that has been lost because the only jiu-jitsu people wore is the one that you watch over there. Sorry, guys. So, again, I'm gonna fight in here. Pa. All right, I'm doing this, you have base, but then I'm attacking here. And then what do you do? Ah, and then I'm here, pa. Oh, see, I'm always changing my angle. So everything is related here. I'm always like, I'm here. I'm not like, oh my God, I want this, I want that. I don't feel comfortable with that, you know? So I stay here, pa, you put your hand here, I go in your arm, pa. I go here, boom. I'm a big on drags. And then maybe I'll drag and maybe I'll go under, and then I go fret some obvious, the cradle of X guard, boom, go under, stuff like that. And that's when things like that comes to the game. But as far as my defense, comes from my offense. The shield frame is just like I said, it's about keeping that distance that keeps me emotionally safe. Sometimes what's emotionally safe for me is not what's emotionally safe for you. And that's what you gotta discover. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
What are your thoughts about when being upside down? Is a good position for you? And you like to lurk to get upside down?
Nah. Really? I like to see the word in this angle. I don't say that I don't do, I mess around with that. You know what I mean? It's important for you to have ability to go there, especially because a lot of times, sometimes, you know, the guy comes to pass your guard, just something simple, just grab my leg here. You know, sometimes the guy goes here, you need to be able to, like, you know, kind of go into these positions to attack and stuff like that. You know what I mean? I'm 35 years old, man. You know what I mean? My neck and things like this. And then I think comes natural ability. My jiu-jitsu is longevity jiu-jitsu. So you might like to invert. Awesome. I invert too. I've done that so much until my shoulder got hurt and my neck doesn't play that much. If you're flexible, amazing. Use it where is the best. But I'm worried about now when someone breaks that and now he has you in a bad position. What type of person gonna show up? The one that inverts? Might not be the one that survived, you know what I mean? So, how old are you now?
29.
I wanna see you in, oh, see? You know what I mean? And that thing is gonna happen. And for me, jiu-jitsu is simple. Be on the top, smash, pass, mount, finish. And everything else along with it is just a cherry on the thing. Nowadays, everybody plays guard, fine. But like, it's 100 ways to do the same thing. What's your goal? To sweep. Well, why all of that to do one goal? You know what I mean? I'll invert if I have to, if I'm losing, whatever. I used to do a lot of this. It's still from the frame. I would go here, I would go there, I would go here, boom, boom. I used to do that a lot. You know what I mean? I used to do that a lot. But, you know, people saving and stuff. It's fine. Like I said, it's just not a game that I really go for it. Because it's not what emotionally makes me comfortable. You know what I mean? You might be comfortable with that. Be my guest. But if you can add a spice to it, that's where things are going to become different. Oh, shit, he's not inverted. He's attacking my neck. Oh, my God, you inverted. Because now what's going to happen is when you're attacking a guy, and the guy now doesn't like it, and he goes away from you, and then, whoa, look at me inverting here. Wow, boom, doing all that stuff. See, I can invert. Okay. It's about game. You know what I mean? It's not about what's, you know, like I said, what can be best for you is not best for me. And I have to respect that. All right, so another position that I saw a lot, that a lot of people are having trouble. And then, in a sense, we're going to go back to shield soon, is this. I saw a lot of people getting caught on this and, you know, not knowing what to do. All right, again, I'm not fighting you here because, of course, I would change. What's your idea to escape this position?
Me?
Yeah.
My idea?
Yeah.
Come on.
And then I pull. Okay. All right. Let go. I'm sorry. Go. You go there, and then you go there. I'm super flexible. Yeah. I'm power. Yeah. I'm here. I'm strong. You what? 220?
30.
Oh, even worse. What else? All right. Let's change a little bit. I'm here. Bah! This position here. I love this. What's your idea? Eita, mais power. Power, power, yeah. Hit a shot, pa, 7 points, yeah. Okay.
right, now I'm gonna talk concept again. Do you guys know what armadillo is? What happened when armadillo is in danger?
That's it.
What happened when you have a stomachache? What happened when someone come and beat you? You don't do this, that's what you did. Again, doesn't matter how big I am, you have to make yourself stronger. By doing this, we're just power. Again, for 5 minutes, I want you to do all of that power and win. Bora, power, push out, let's go, boom. I will be the first one to do that. But let's imagine if you like, let's go. Oh, how much time, Xande? No time. Yeah, you're gonna do that? You're gonna think twice, right? So that's the jiu-jitsu I want you to have. That one's good for 5 minutes. The other one might be good for your whole life. And I want you to be able to go to your school and say, let's train. Oh, about the time? No, let's just train. I've had many black belts world champion come to my academy. Shouldn't I say yes, let's go? What about the time? I'm like, what time? Oh no, I don't train without a time. I'm like, what? Nah, come on, man. What happens if in the back alley and it's dark and you have to fight for your life? Oh, I have 5 minutes? No. All right. You switch now. So, the guy got me in my head. Well, that was the first position. Now you're in your side. You're on side. Yeah, pa, right there. Okay, so, what messing up everything is because I cannot turn my head. How am I gonna move my hip if I'm here? I can't. All right, so what I'm gonna do, guys, is put my hand as close as I can here. I don't wanna put on the shoulder because I might get caught on a wrist lock. It's more like I wanna put my hand here. All right, pa. That's the first thing. Put some pressure, go. Put some pressure. Yeah, pressure, right? Too petty? You said too petty? I think all they have in the room. Pa, right there. Now, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go. Oh, where I am? Same position. So, what did I do? I didn't do movement. I adjust myself. Brazilian dancing, pa, 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 pa. And I want my head, chin down and head. So, one thing that Sal taught me a long time ago was this. Stay there, pass my guard. Can't get my head. And I'm strong. I'm armadillo. Head ready to bloom back. So anytime the guys here, guy, I see a lot of guys doing like this, like that, but man. Well, the guy's pressure here on elbow, connect, turn my hip. That's the only two things I can move on. Is this and this. And a little bit of this. If I give this, he might catch me there. So I stay here. And I put my hand as sneak my hand. Now on. Hip, shoulder, hip, shoulder, hip, shoulder. Head, head, head. Shield. And go back away. And here I am out. Okay? The only thing you have to be really worried about is the mount. Everything away is good for me. Why? Centripetal power. You guys know what that is? When something spins and goes away, it's awesome because it's going away from me. So what happens is once I'm here, he's away. What do you want to do? Oh, he's away. And that's what I want. So that's why when I frame, there's a pass here, very common, when a guy goes here and do a back step that way. Do a back step. No, back step.
Back step.
Just step your leg out. No. Like this. Put your knee on the floor and do a back step here.
Oh.
Yeah, like that. So when I feel that's happening, go. He's away. And that's what I want to create. Pressure, bad. Move, create that energy away. Once the energy goes away, I close, get back myself in, and I blow back away. It's okay to cry to mom a little bit and then go back. All right, so what we're gonna do here is gonna connect my head,
and go this side. Up. Here, here. And open here. Try to mount. Right there. So see, now let it go of this and try to get my underhook. Go. Now the other one comes in. So, and then you play with that, okay? So, the guy at the top is gonna be like this. If I go for the mount, you get this one. If I try to go here or step away, you go for the other one and put the shield in. If I turn, the shield is there. There's no way possible. Any questions? Let's practice and then I'll go around and fix you guys, okay? One, two. See, now you give this, and now it's another problem that you might have, because now when you move, this is caught now. I'd rather be here than here. I don't like being here much anymore. Okay. When I'm here, I'm usually here already, you know what I mean? And I kind of like switch from this or to that. Because here, sometimes I feel it's easy for you to hide that. You still can use it. I'm not saying that it's not effective. It is effective. But make sure when you do that, you look for your head to come out of my shoulder. That's what you need to do. Yeah, so if you get a chance to do this, pa, now, yeah, but move this more out. Ah, yeah. It's okay to use.
Am I using it just a frame to get to the guard?
No, because now I don't have it. Because sometimes, look, because it's something that you want to look for. Put your head here. Now I don't have it. What okay. I have there?
Yeah, you can't press.
Now it. I have to change to this or to this.
Okay.
But as I change, the shield is already there. The shield. Ah, to save you. Yeah.
Okay.
Not necessary. Go there, but. Because I have to change. That's why I asked you if you're comfortable. Okay, for that specific situation, I saw many people getting caught on that and not knew what to do. So pretty much everything we did was top knee, right? But let's not forget about the bottom knee. The bottom knee is always there. For example, let's start something very simple as just a kezagatami from side control. Just go, no, side control. No, kezagatami. Boom. Just like that. Yeah, boom. The guy's right here, right? So, when I'm in this position, we call the sensitive knee. Both of my knees, they're independent. But they're sensitive for anything that happens. Put your knee in my stomach. Put your knee in my stomach, go. They're already there, see? I'm ready for two things, for this or for just close armadillo, right? So my elbows on the floor, I'm gonna turn and my knee is connecting and I'm moving to push him away, right? He faces my leg now. But same thing, I'm here, I'm turning and I'm bringing my knee back in so I can escape less, okay? So now, go back. There's one movement I want you guys to pay attention. It's a stand up in base, but with my elbow on the floor. So I want you guys to just pay attention to this movement here. Here. Okay, it's not this. It's this, all right? So are we clear with that? Cool. So now, he was caught, was you that was caught? Switch. So that's another position. Now let me get bad. I want you to, yes. Bad spot. Everything is open. I can use my chin to tickle him. I can punch his stomach. I can look at the picture. Gallery.com, pa. Bad for him. So what's your idea there? Really? Para. No, stop. Stop. Go back. You blooming too early, man. A lot of power there. Let's go again. Fernando Tererê, boa. Bração pro Tererê aí. Não, allow me. No. Stop. Let me get what I want, and then I want you to see your reaction again. Okay, bad, right? So what's your idea again? That's why, stop. What's he missing? No. He's spread out, we know that. He's not preparing. He's just moving. He's not preparing. Survival first, and then escape. He's not surviving, he's just escaping. He's doing power, so switch now. So you're probably like 145, 150, 60?
76.
76? Okay. Oh, he's there. Pa. But he's not preparing. So first thing you wanna do here is bringing him down to my hips. Because when you face my leg, you're doing a shoulder control, not a hip control. Okay? When he's facing me, face me. Just face me, yeah. It's more a hip control. All the time you turn away, you turn into a shoulder control. All right? Again, this is not the whole seminar, we'll talk about it. So now, my shoulders are caught, and he's just he's gonna step out. So first thing I'm gonna do again, I still don't close it. Because if he steps out, I move. Boom. And here I am. Okay, so I'm always ready for his movement. I think I was talking to one of the guys. Everything I'm giving is to get to a point that I need, the other guy have to move, otherwise it's silly. Requires a movement. You know, like I was asking him, he was in that position. Are you comfortable? Yeah, I'm comfortable. Look at me right here, I'm comfortable. He's already out of the position. So the comfort I'm saying is like, are you still in the position? That's where I mean comfortable. Okay, so let's imagine this guy is 250 pounds. Pa. So first thing you wanna do is get here. That's the first thing you wanna do. Is get my elbow here. Can I escape here? Yes. I could escape here. But sometimes the guy is too heavy, right? So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna control that belt, keep moving as much, even if he steps out. And now I escape. Okay? Now, again, I want you to think about small, turn, adjust, and then move, because I'm gonna have to move. So you have to be ready for my movement. If I move and you don't move, shame on you. And that's the idea. Because over there, if he moves and you don't have a reaction, you're behind. Show it out. But let me go bad on you. No, allow me. What are we gonna do first? Boom, 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 boom. Hip, bam, bam, bam. Keep moving out. Now move up. Isso aí, ó. Now I'm like, oh shit. Pa. Yeah. Vibe, keep moving. You can't take that long. Because eventually I will step out. But you were already in a good position. Again. Switch it. Hold it down, hold it down. So. Pago. I'm here. Isso. Now I'm like, oh. I'm gonna completely step out. Now, isso, because I cannot go there. If I come flat, that's exactly the space that he wants. Because my hip is here. If I turn, my hip is there. If I keep pressure, that's when we're gonna go number two. You know? So let's imagine I'm like super, super heavy, okay? So it's creating a situation. So I'm gonna step out. It might be before I step out or after, but let's go here. Try to skate. But you're not doing, right? Okay, stop right there. Now, no. Don't use your hand, it's your elbow. Move your hip. Go back. Not your hand, it's your elbow. Because this is strong, man. Now go back. Go back again. Pa. Now let's imagine maybe the guy is super strong. He's here. Come, stop. Extend your arm, go in your elbow. Come up on your elbow. Come up on your right elbow. Okay, stop. It's not a hip escape. Stand up in base. Now go back to my back. Go to my back. Boom. Better. Okay. Switch. So, go out. So when I'm here, it's not this. It's this. And I'm right there. to his back. Might be on the guard, might be on the back. That would be my ultimate goal. Okay? Any questions on that one? Now let's go on three. One, two, three.